Hiya.
Hello.
Welcome to the Geeky Girls Knit podcast. I'm Cece, also known as Java Pearl.
I'm Dammy, also known as Dammy Stoodles.
And we're glad to have you today. Today is Wednesday, the 19th of April, 2017, and this is episode 239. One more episode and we'll be in the home stretch to 250. That's so exciting. We'd like to say a big welcome back. We love you guys. To all our returning viewers, and a big hiya to any new viewers. Thanks for giving us a shot. We hope you enjoy the show. So, Dammy, we had some people introduce themselves in our Ravelry group this week. Why don't you give them a shout-out?
Okay. Christiane, who is Bernisa from California. Sierra, who is Owls and Orchids from North Carolina. Kirsten, who is the Bristol Crafter from Bristol. Charlotte, who is Charlotte M. Hayes from Edinburgh. Julie, who is Kaylin Saunders from Iowa. And Deanna, who is Rathalay from Alaska.
Welcome. We're so glad to have you guys. Thanks for introducing yourselves in the Ravelry group. So, Dammy, if somebody is not a member of our Ravelry group, what should they do and why?
You should join and introduce yourself in our introductions thread because you will get a shout-out on our next episode, and you will be able to participate in all our cals and giveaways.
That is right. Well, we have a good amount of stuff to talk about today, including the new Doctor Who episode. Series 10 has started. So why don't we get started? Here we go.
And now we're going to talk about what's on our needles.
So what's on your needles, Dammy?
I'm still working on my Karagan socks. It's because I'm using all the yarn and so it's taking forever. There's the back side.
Okay, so tell us about it.
This is the French Vanilla Cappuccino sock pattern. It's on US 0.5, 2.5 millimeters, and the yarn is Easy Knits Deeply Wicked Plus in the Neon and Night colorway.
So you are increasing to make them be, fit your, calf? Is that what it's called? Calves? Yes, calves.
Moo.
Moo.
Calves.
Yes, calves. Cow. Calves.
Not calves. Calves.
Oh, is this going to be another crown thing?
Well, it's LVS, not LFS.
But you're calves.
Yes, that's it. Not calves.
Calves.
Yes, that's
what I said, calves.
No, you were saying calves.
So, how much more yarn do you have to go?
I just weighed it and I had 69 grams and I need to stop the whole sock at 55 grams.
Because you had how much to start with?
111.
So you need to stop probably around 60 to do the cuff.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, but I love how it's pooling.
But it's like it's not taking hardly any to do a set of increases. And so it just keeps getting bigger.
Would you like me to tell you why?
Why?
It is because there is this thing called the black hole of knitting where it never ends. The yarn just replenishes itself. Kind of like that story in the Bible where the oil just kept getting replenished. That's what it is. It's the black hole of knitting.
Mm.
Mm-hmm. So, now you know.
Okay.
But can you show them how it's pooling now that you've increased? Yeah. On the other side, it's like mostly black. Yeah. Oh, so pretty. I love how it's pooling.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay. Are you working on anything else?
I am still working on the Indiebro Craft Crawl 2017 socks. These are being troublemaker socks. They're on US 1.5, 2.5 millimeters, and now US 2.5, 3 millimeters. I need to add that.
Yes.
And it's on Ginger's hand-dyed sheepish sock in a colorway I can't tell you the name of or show you. And so I had finished the first sock, because I have to make two of these. And so I'd finished it. I'd bound it off and everything. And then we realized the leg was not stretchy enough to go over the heel of our foot.
Do you think it's stretchy enough? Do you think it's stretchy enough?
Okay.
Okay.
And so I had to undo it.
And then we had another knitting attack.
Yes, the needle broke.
So this is the first time I've ever had this happen. This is the first time that we've used this particular size out of the Hiya Sharps interchangeable sock set. And there was a default in the needle. The screw snapped in half inside the adapter. But we were able to be in touch with Haya Haya and with the person that we bought the, I bought the set from, and it's all being taken care of. In fact, a new set of needles and adapters just arrived this morning. So you'd had to take a time out, but now you can get back to them. Mm-hmm. So that's the first time I've ever had that happen with Haya Hayas. I've had humongous issues with Chagu. I don't even own any Chagu anymore. I think I snapped like, what, six sets of them or something? They're not a good choice for me. So, but I'm glad that they were taking care of things and everything like that. So, okay, are you working on anything else?
No. So, what are you working on?
Well, I am working on four things right now. First up is my zigzag blanket. This is the 10 stitch zigzag pattern by Frankie Brown. I'm on US 4s, 3.5 mil needles, and the yarn is
Gnome, Acres, House, Gnome, and the Wonder Woman colorway.
And I've only got, I think, four zigzags left on this row. And then Dammy, I was like, hey, help me pick out a yarn for the next one.
Birds.
She like picked out the yarn that she had just given me. I was like, don't you want to look? Birds. So it'll be the Wood Pigeon will be the next stripe. So you'll see that by next week. All right. I had been able to pick back up on working on my Joss wrap. Because I finished a project. I'll show you in a minute. This is the Joss pattern by Lily Johnson, who is Truly Myrtle. I'm on US 5s, 3.75 mil needles, and I'm using Woolmize Sock and Wool 80-20 Twin in the Nobody is Perfect colorway, and Woolmize Wild Thing 80-20 Twin. in the We're Different colorway. I always mess that up. So I haven't made a ton of progress on this, but I have added, the yarn's caught. So you start right here at a point, and then you're increasing, and so right here is where this section started, and I think I need like between 10 and 15 more stripes. And then I get to start on the lace section, and I'm so excited. So I'm back to working on that, and this is living in the Stitching Plaza Winnie the Pooh bag with pink heffalumps inside, because pink heffalumps are the best. And then I am working on birthday socks for my bestie's husband, Jeremy, and I have told him that I must love him a whole lot to make socks for him. I'll show you why. Let me tell you what I'm using. I'm using my French Vanilla Cappuccino sock pattern. I'm on US 1.5, 2.5 mil needles, and the yarn is Third Vault Yarns Librarian Sock in the Espresso Campana and Battlestar Galactica colorway. Are you ready? I finished the first one. Are you ready for this? Yeah. He has ginormous feet, and he knows he does. We discuss it every time I knit socks for him. So, first one is done, and I don't have the entire toe finished, but I am working on the toe, and then it'll get switched to Zoom Zoom needles, and I'll be working on it. It will, as will the Joss wrap, these will get put in Stash Dash Hiatus, which is, Stash Dash is a knit along hosted by the Knit Girls. And there's a thread in their group right now about potential rule changes. So if you are interested in seeing some different things in the rules, you should go look at that. But yeah, those will go in Stash Dash Hiatus to finish once Stash Dash starts. And then the last thing I'm working on, so our pal Jess, who is the owner of Ginger Twist Studio, which is our favorite local yarn store, and she dyes a line of yarn called Ginger's Hand Dyed. In fact, that's what you are knitting the Edinburgh Craft Crawl socks with right now. Anyway, she is getting married later this year, and she is wanting to have knitted bunting at her wedding. And so she figured out that she needs like 250 triangles. So she just told some of us, if you want to knit some, I would be happy to have them. So we are using the Swatchtastic pattern by Tin Can Knits. It's a free pattern, and it's got lots of different options for ways you can do it, and it's a good way to swatch for projects. So right now, so I'm using US 6's 4 mil needles, and I just went through my stash and found green yarn. And so this was the first one I finished. I'm not weaving all the ends at once. This is on Cascade 220 in the Highland Green colorway. So there's one finished, and I'm knitting on one right now. I have enough yarn, just enough yarn for one more. So I am working on that. I might have it finished by the time we finish podcasting today. So I'm just going to knit up as many as I can until I get tired of knitting them or until I run out of green yarn. So I've got some other skeins of green yarn in my leftover stash. So so I'm just knitting up some bunting triangles for her wedding. So yeah, and that is everything that is on our needles, I think. So let's move on to the next segment.
And now we're going to talk about her finished projects.
And I have two. So first up, how adorable is this preemie hat? Oh my gosh, I think this may be in like my top five favorite preemie hats I've knit. This is from my free top-down preemie hat pattern on Ravelry. This is number 16 for the year. It's on US 6's 4mm needles, and the yarn is Janelle Baby 4-ply in the white and light blue colorways. And this is the yarn that I showed y'all, I think I showed them last week, did I? Maybe? Anyway, at church a week ago, a lady gave it to me. She's chatted with me before about me knitting preemie hats, and she gave me this yarn, and it was 4-ply, so I just held a strand of the blue with a strand of the white, and I just love how it turned out, and it's pom-pom, you guys. Is so freaking squishy. Love it. So there's that. And then the other thing, damn, is modeling. This is my MPG for someone special. It's a secret, I'm not telling you. This is the Multi-Purpose Garment MPG by Fibertown Designs. Emily is her name, and she has the Fibertown podcast. This is on US 7's 4.5mm needles, and the yarn is Chopped Ginger Wool Project Beside Winsleydale in the natural black colorway and Teeswater DK in the boysenberry colorway. And I did add some West Yorkshire spinners in the charcoal colorway because I ran out of yarn. So Dammy is going to model this. This is one way you can wear it as a cowl. Okay, what do you want to show them next?
I need help.
You can wear it as a cute little capelet. You'd have to arrange it, yeah, like that. Or you can wear it.
I can't move my arms without it falling off my shoulders. Ah!
You can wear it as a hood. How cute is that? Okay, take it off and I will show them what it looks like. So I striped it. Let's see, I'm trying to get it to where I can show them how it kind of folds. There we go. So I striped it.
I'm getting wool everywhere.
Sorry. I used two rows of the black with two rows of the boysenberry all the way up. And then you do some short rows and everything to give you the shape for the hood. And it's so sheepy and yummy, and I really hope my friend that I made this for will love it. It smells so good because it's sheepy. And that is everything I finished. So that was my retraction project from last week that I said I wouldn't finish anything except for zigzag stripes and preemie hats.
No, probably bunting.
See, I need to check the rules and see if I can... Well, I know I'll be able to... Well, I don't know. I need to check and see if how it might be able to be part of Stash Dash. I don't know if I could count the individual triangles or if I knit all the ones I'm going to knit, if I could count everything of them. Or if they're not eligible at all since it's not a full finished project. Although it's finished on my end. I just, you know what I'm saying? So I need to check the rules on that. But from now until Stash Dash starts, I'll only be finishing preemie hats, zigzag stripes, and potentially bunting triangles. So So let's now move on to the next segment. And now it's time for our favorite part of the show, yummies. What are yummies, Dammy?
Yummies are our current favorite things, things we like, things we want to talk to you about.
Yummies. So let's start with, I am still continuing to participate in the hashtag SSS Vita challenge, which is a challenge to vlog every day in April. And you can watch these vlogs on YouTube. You can go to youtube.com/geekygirlsknit. So this week on the videos, I have talked about my favorite authors are Trek to Arthur's Seat, which we're going to talk about in just a minute. My favorite actors and actresses. Happy Easter, a little peek at our Easter service at church. My tattoos, I have 4 of them and I tell you all about them. Design inspiration, so what inspires me when I design, and also my favorite sock yarns. And then today I talked about, am I a morning person or night owl, and when I'm most productive. So, and that will be continuing through the end of April. So go watch if you haven't had a chance to. All right, Dammy, we went on a little trek this week.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to tell them where it was we went and everything?
Arthur's Seat.
So it's like I don't even know how to describe it.
Big hill.
Big hill, rocks, beauty. Yeah, we're going to show you pictures and video in just a minute, but we had kind of a Arthur's Seat fail. Is that like a knitting fail? When Arthur's Seat attacks, the trails, the paths are not labeled. And we went on the wrong one. And by the time we realized it, and we're going to trek all the way back to the start, I knew I would not have enough energy to be able to do the whole trail again, the correct one. So we still had some beautiful views. There was lots of lovely stuff. We had a picnic. And had a nice long walk, and it was really pretty. What do you think?
Yeah.
So, hopefully we can go try again and go on the right path. So we're going to stop right here, and we'll put in some videos and pictures from our trek, and then we'll be right back. So we're about to go on an adventure. There's Dammy. There's the Hubs. Do you know where we're going? Dammy, tell them. Arthur's Seat. We're going to climb Arthur's Seat, but we have to catch a bus first. So, here we go. Climbing Arthur's Seat, and what did we find? Pink rocks. Thank you. So that was our trek to Arthur's Seat. I saw something like flying out of the corner of my eye. It's the window curtain blowing in the breeze, but I was like, I thought something just flew in our flat, but it didn't. So hopefully we can try again and get up the right path and be able to take more film and pictures for you. So that was our Arthur's Seat trick. All right, Dammy, you have something that you want to share with us that is yummy.
Yes. The cast of The Great Comet performed on Good Morning America on Friday. It was really good.
It was good. Yeah. So I've put a link in the show notes where you can watch the video.
Mm-hmm.
And then you were saying that they're going to be on what?
They're going to be on the Today Show next Friday.
So not 2 days?
No.
So next week. Okay. So like the 28th, is that what it is?
Yes.
Yes, the 28th. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Are they going to perform the same thing as they did on Good Morning America?
I'm thinking probably so, or okay. Something similar to it.
Okay. And you were saying that that the Today Show is also having like a musicals week?
Yes, apparently. So like the weekdays next week, they're going to have performances from Amelie, Anastasia, Dear Evan Hansen, Comet, and Groundhog Day. Stop! Be nice!
I hate that movie with a passion.
Be nice.
It is one of those movies that is right up there with Elf that I cannot watch.
It's not gross or anything, is it?
No, it's just, I don't know, it just makes me so angry.
Annoying?
I'm very annoyed with it and it makes me angry.
Why does it make you angry?
I don't know, because I don't know, it just does. It just builds up this thing in me that I'm just like, ah, stop.
Oh, okay. Be nice about the musical, though.
I can't believe they made a musical out of it. But anyway, Elf, I cannot watch because of the spaghetti scene. And what's the other one that is on my list? Oh, Face Off. That's so creepy. Oh my gosh, it's so creepy. Those are my three most hated movies of all time. Were you going to say something else?
Yes.
Okay, please say.
So, yes, the performance was really good and you should watch it.
Yeah, it's only like 4 minutes or so.
Yes.
So.
And all their costumes are so pretty.
I know. They are. I watched it with you.
I know, I'm just telling you again in case you
forgot. In case I forgot? Yeah.
Yes, and because they are all so pretty.
Yes, they're lovely. Lovely, lovely. But they're evicting Josh.
Yes, Josh Groban must leave July 2nd or else.
Would you like to tell them what happened to make this happen?
So they posted a video saying, like, you know, Josh Groban is only in the musical through July 2nd, so if you want to see him, you should get tickets before that date. But they worded it in the video, Josh Groban must leave July 2nd. Like, they're evicting him.
Bye-bye, Josh the second.
Forcing him out. Yeah. Josh number two.
Josh number two. Because he was the second Josh to come.
Mm-hmm.
So, I wish we could see it. It's a little far to go, though. So, all right, do we have any other yummies?
I don't think so.
All right, well then let's talk about hashtag GGK Crafty Pad. What is it, Dammy?
It stands for Geeky Girls Knit Crafty Photo a Day Challenge. So we have a list of photo prompts for each month. So you take a look at the prompt for that day, take a picture related to it, and post it anywhere you like. But we pick our favorites from Instagram.
So we are continuing this month with numbers, and so please feel free to interpret it however you wish. Like, what is today? The 19th. I have 19 stitches left to bind off, or I've knit 19 inches on my sweater, or whatever. Or you can do like what I'm doing, and it's just like, today, the 19th, is whatever. That's what I'm doing. All right, Dammy, what are we about to show them?
2 photos from us that we liked and 5 photos from other people that we liked.
Here come the photos. So those were the photos. Great job, everybody. We are not going to forget to film this segment this week. Last week we forgot to film this. And then I was like editing and I was like, crap, damn you, we didn't film this. I don't know what happened. We were excited to talk about what we were reading and watching and listening to, apparently. So it's never too late to join in. Just take a look at the prompt, interpret it however you wish. Post your picture on Instagram. Make sure in the comment or the caption you use the hashtag GGKCraftyPad because that's how we find your photos. And yours might get chosen. All right, Dami, we have one upcoming event that hopefully we'll be attending.
Yes, the Indiebra Craft Crawl on Saturday the 17th of June.
So it's from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. And there is an after party. And I'm putting on the screen right now the, they call it like the passport, where it has information about all the shops that are participating. And if you go on the crawl and have your passport stamped for all the shops you go to, you get to be entered into prize raffles. So, so hopefully we'll be able to attend that. It just depends on if we're still in the UK then. So we'll let you know when we know. All right, we have a lot to talk about in our next segment, so we should probably get started.
Now we're going to talk about what we are reading, watching, and listening to.
So what are you reading, Dami?
I'm still reading Anne of Green Gables by Lucy Maud Montgomery. I don't really remember where I am in the book right now, but I am still enjoying it. So.
Do you know anything that has happened this week?
No, because I talked about Diana getting drunk last week.
Mm-hmm.
And the reconciliation after that. I don't know where I am.
See, and it all starts running together for yes. me, like from book to book, and I'm like, wait, I don't know if this is in this book or the next book.
Yeah. But I am enjoying it, and good. That's what matters.
That's right. Okay, are you reading anything else?
No. So what are you reading?
A lot of things.
Too many things.
Well, I finished a book. I finished 3 books this week.
Then how many did you start?
3. So, I finished reading You Are Free, Be Who You Already Are by Rebecca Lyons. It was a very good book. I would highly recommend it. Really enjoyed that. And so I started reading another nonfiction book. I'm reading Year of Yes, How to Dance It Out, Stand in the Sun, and Be Your Own Person by Shonda Rhimes. And she's the one behind Scandal and Murder and Grey's Anatomy.
Mm-hmm.
So, but it's more of like a memoir, so I'm able to like read it faster than I would read like the previous book, You Are Free by Rebecca Lyons. I had to like only read like a chapter a day and have time to really like process it and everything. This one, I'm not having to do that. Like I read, I think 3 chapters yesterday while you were making dinner. So, and then I'm continuing to reread Shadow of Night by Deborah Harkness in real time using the Reading Companion, and I'm enjoying that. And then I finished reading The Gender Fall, which is the 5th book in the Gender Game series by Bella Forrest. I didn't enjoy this one as much as I did the previous ones, but it was still good. And it's a Kindle Unlimited one. Gotta love that. And then I'm reading the Pat of Silverbush series by Lucy Maud Montgomery. I'm fairly certain that I've read these before, but it's been a long time because I'm remembering some things, but there's other stuff I'm not remembering. So I finished reading the first book and I'm reading the second book, but that first book, sobbing, crying my eyes out, Dami came to tell me goodnight and she was like, are you okay? And I'm like, no, this person just died. And like then, so I told her goodnight and everything and you went to bed and then I was sitting in bed crying for like another 20 minutes. Because it was very emotional. I'm not going to tell you who died because that's a spoiler. But oh my gosh, it was emotional. I'm not a lot of the way into book 2. But right now, just comparing what I've read with book 1, I enjoy book 1 more. But that could change as as it goes, as I read more in book two.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay, so after our, well, we discussed this a little bit, I think, on last week's podcast or the week before about how much I love Harrison Ford. He's, like, my favorite. I like him a lot. And that we needed...
Not your favorite actor, just your favorite in general.
Sure. So anyway, I was like, oh, we should rewatch some of his movies. And it had been forever since we'd watched Air Force One. So as recovery from Arthur Seat, we rewatched Air Force One. Oh my gosh, I forgot he flew the plane in the end. But then somebody commented and told us. And I was like, oh my gosh, yes, I forgot. That was such a good one. And it was so crazy, some of the people that were in it, because I was like, oh. It's funny like that when you watch a movie that it's been a number of years since it came out, and because it's been like 20 years, I think, and then watch it and then see some what some of these actors and actresses that were maybe just starting out and they're like bigger deals now. And then we also rewatched all four Indiana Jones movies. Why does it always have to be snakes? I had to keep turning away and be like, tell me when the snakes are off the screen, or tell me when the bugs are off the screen, or the spiders, or whatever. We had to watch the fourth one, even though it's not as good as the rest.
Aliens.
Aliens. Why did it have to be aliens? Oh, wait, what? Yeah, so we rewatched those four, and that was fun. So, okay, why don't you talk about the next one, because I've been talking for a while.
We are rewatching season four of Eureka. We just finished season four, actually. And so now we're ready for the final season.
Well, there's a Christmas special first.
The Christmas special and the final season.
Yes. Allison got sent to Titan. Accidentally.
Or, is it Titan? Because someone else was controlling it and changing the destination coordinates.
Right. You think it's Beverly?
I don't remember.
I don't remember either. And Joe left. Made me cry.
She comes back, though.
Yeah, she does come back, but I don't know how long she's gone for. I don't know if she comes back immediately or not. Like, in the next few episodes or not. Yeah, it's been fun to have Will Wheaton and...
Felicia Day.
Yeah, Felicia Day in it, because they are fun. I really like them both. So... Okay, the Hubs and I are rewatching Lost. We have, I think, 5 episodes left of the whole series.
Who is Daniel's half-sister that he was telling Desmond how to find?
Penny.
Penny?
But not, I mean, like, in the other timeline, that's not how it is.
Oh, okay.
I don't think.
No, because Eloise... And Woodmore aren't a thing in the other timeline, are they?
I think they were for a while, maybe. Hmm. Oh, it's all start running together. Well, especially because there's multiple timelines, and you're like, wait, what? Which timeline does this happen in? Yeah, I only have enough yarn just to knit this one. I should probably count and see where I'm at to make sure I haven't knit too far. Yeah, so we only have, I think, 5 episodes left, and so it's all, like, culminating. But it was so nice, the episode we watched last night, to have Libby back. She was in the alternate timeline.
Oh, yeah, I was like, who's Libby?
Yeah, Libby back. And Sun and Jim still have not found each other yet.
Oh.
I remember a very tragic ending for them in the next 5 episodes.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Well, isn't it a really tragic ending for everyone?
Yeah, but if I'm
they all die.
But if I'm remembering right, Sun and Jin drown.
Oh.
I'm pretty sure that's what happened.
Okay.
So, and Charlie was back. That was fun.
He almost died.
He did.
Was that fun?
Oh, and then Desmond hit John Locke with a car.
Oh, yeah.
He ran him over in the wheelchair.
Why?
I don't remember. That was like almost at the very end of the episode last night.
No, and that
like,
was the end of the
episode. Oh, was it? I'm like, I can't remember why. This is in the alternate timeline. Anyway. Okay. Why don't you talk about the next thing?
We are watching season 4 of Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. And it's scary. Because Ada has now taken over everything.
40. I need 4 more increases.
But I saw a thing, you remember Agent Trip from like season two?
I'm remembering the name, but I can't visualize who the person is.
Triplet. He's bald. I'll show you him later, but he's coming back.
Oh, really?
He died, but he's going to be in the framework.
Oh.
He was the one that got turned to stone with the Terrigenesis thing.
Oh, okay, yes.
And then he crumbled away.
Yes. So he's in the Agents of Hydra framework.
Yes.
There's a new episode for us to watch tonight.
Yes, I don't know if he's in this one.
Okay.
But, yay, Trip!
Yeah. Okay, why don't you talk about the next thing, because then I have a couple to talk about.
We are watching Criminal Minds Beyond Boundary Borders.
Boundary Borders.
Season 2.
Watch 2 episodes.
Yes. And in the first one, Jackson was undercover in Tijuana. The second one had Kevin Tran from Supernatural. And I'm the one who noticed. And I don't watch Supernatural. She didn't notice.
Because I was like knitting, and then you were like, hey, it's Kevin from Supernatural.
I didn't remember his last name. I just said, hey, it's Kevin.
So apparently they have a thing for Supernatural actors, because last week they had God/Chuck and the angel Gabriel.
Yeah.
So I wonder,
who's next?
Do they film Supernatural in Canada or in L.A.?
I don't know.
Because it would make sense if it was in...
I don't think Criminal Minds is in Canada.
I don't think so either. Well, because a lot of the sci-fi shows are filmed in Canada, and there's a lot of recurring actors and actresses that are in various things.
Mm-hmm. But Canada is very small.
Was it Supernatural that I saw that it was going to have...
Amanda Tapping.
Yes, Amanda Tapping is going to direct.
She's Canadian. No, she's not.
No.
But she's in the Canada
thing because
circle.
Because of SG-1 and Atlantis and...
What is Sanctuary.
Sanctuary. Oh, we need to rewatch that. Maybe we should rewatch that next.
Okay.
After Eureka's over. I think the Hubs would approve.
Didn't they have some crossover episodes with something else that was on sci-fi at the same time?
Possibly. I really like Sanctuary. Okay. Let's talk about Big Bang Theory season 10. There was a Fun with Flags retrospective.
I'm helping.
Thank you. It was kind of funny. And then they did a behind the scenes of the Fun with Flags retrospective something. Gosh, it was funny. And Hallie had her first day at daycare, and it was very traumatic for everyone. So
it was traumatic.
Because
was it traumatic for Hallie?
No, it was for Howard and... What's her name? Oh, Bernadette. And what's his name that owns the comic book shop? Stuart, because he lives with them. Yeah, so it was all traumatic for all of them. Okay, Supernatural Season 12. The British Men of Letters broke into the bunker. To find out about Dean and Sam, and they bugged the bunker too.
Bemol.
Those British Men of Letters. Okay, why don't you talk about the next thing, because then I'm going to talk about the next two.
Okay, well, I want to talk about the next one too.
Well, yeah.
Okay, so The Blacklist Redemption. This was the season finale?
I don't think it's coming back.
Okay.
I think it was just a one-off, but
so
I could be wrong.
If they have any more stuff, I guess it'll be in the actual Blacklist.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That would
so
be my
Tom's
guess.
Father, Howard, his name is Howard.
His name is John Locke.
No, was actually the one who was evil the entire time, but Tom's mother isn't so great either, so they're not pretty good. And Howard framed Tom's mother, Scotty, that's her name, and Tom has no clue that all of this is happening.
His father backstabbed his mother.
Yeah, you wrote that.
I did write that. This is my last row.
Ooh.
And then I can bind off, which is good since I only have this much yarn left. Mm-hmm. Okay. Doctor Who Series 10 started this weekend. So this was the episode called The Pilot. And this is Peter Capaldi's final series.
Oh.
Yes. So I adored that he had the pictures of River and Susan on his desk. We watched the episode twice because we watch it once through And then we watch it again to take notes and further understand what happens.
Did you see the cup of old Sonic screwdrivers?
Yes, there were several different Doctor screwdrivers also on the desk.
I didn't know he kept them. I thought he just broke them all and got rid of them.
I know. So that was kind of cool. Loved him playing the electric guitar again. Oh, that's so fun. Okay, to me, when the episode started and through probably about half of it, they were, in my opinion, they were playing Bill as very ditzy and not smart and...
I don't think she's ditzy.
That, I mean, my watching it through the second time, after about halfway through the episode, then I feel like they weren't playing it that way anymore. But at the beginning, I feel like they were playing it off as like she was just really ditzy. And I also feel like they are, that she has a lot of similarities to Rose.
I wouldn't have said Rose. I would have said Donna, maybe.
See, I think Rose, because, like, Rose was just, like, working at a, what was it? Was she working, like, a shop?
Yeah, like a clothes store.
Or something. And she kind of didn't have any vision for her being a part of the bigger thing. It was just kind of a day-to-day thing. And Bill is kind of the same way. What is in the vault? Oh my gosh, what is he protecting? And I, oh my gosh, when he went back and took pictures of Bill's mom for her, oh my gosh. And the inside of his coat was blue, so what happened to the red?
He still had that one. He just has two different ones.
Okay,
the one that's blue on the inside, it looks like it's like kind of bigger and like velvet on the outside. And so
okay,
there, I think it's two different.
It's kind of like 10 had
the brown one and the blue one.
Yeah. Okay. When Bill asked the doctor, "Do you know any sci-fi?" Oh my gosh! And then that joke kind of played through several times. Oh my gosh, it was so funny. It took her forever to realize about the TARDIS. Oh my gosh. I was like, sweetie, it's not a lift. It's bigger on the inside, but how long did it take you to figure this out? And then, like, you get off somewhere else and you're like, this can't be a lift. It's moved, but the room's still there.
She's trying really hard. She's trying.
And he tells her to go past the macaroon dispenser in the TARDIS to get to the toilet. I'm like, oh my gosh, that's fabulous. And I caught this the first time we watched through, and then I was reading something, and then definitely again, when they are discussing about Mind Wipe, because he made a promise to someone. Do we know who? No. I guess it's related to the vault. And so he was going to wipe Bill's mind, but she convinced him not to. But the Impossible Girl theme was playing, and it was, so Clara's theme was playing in that. So I thought that was an interesting connection there. So that's everything I wrote down. Do you have other thoughts about this?
I really liked it. I really liked this episode. Because I didn't know, like, the past couple series, I guess, I haven't been, like, really big on. But I really liked this episode.
Yeah. Clara was not one of my favorites. I mean, I liked her, but she just wasn't like, oh my gosh, I love this, like I did with, well, River wasn't a true companion, but you guys all know I adore River. She's my very favorite. But some of the other companions, Amy and Rory, so Clara was okay, but there were some points where I was like, okay, you know. So I'm interested to see how they continue to develop Bill's character throughout the series 10. And then also who will be the next Doctor. There was a rumor. I can't remember what his name was. Anyway, there was a rumor. He's another British actor. Possibility. But I don't know when they're going to announce it. They're going to probably drag it out for us for a while. So, yeah. So that was the pilot. Okay, and then I watched the Broadchurch. It was the Series 3 finale, but it was a whole show finale. And they dealt with quite a few of this stuff, issues from, like, the first series and that whole case that started it all. But in this third series, the crime that they had been investigating, I felt like from the very first episode that that teenage boy who was the perpetrator was part of it. And man, he was just like, his brain was thinking a whole lot different way than it should have. So yeah, I'm glad they caught him. So yeah, so finished watching that show, and then what we're listening to. I am still listening to the Spotify CeCe and Dami Love Musicals playlist. I'm obsessed with it. I play it all the time and sing, and Dami gets upset with me because I'm not saying the right words, and I'm like, oh. And when Hamilton comes on and I'm like dancing, and I'm sure you're just like, Mama, please stop.
You're right.
And I listen to it sometimes at the coffee shop, and I have to be like careful because I don't want people to be like, what is this woman doing? What have you been listening to?
I've been listening to Hadestown still because I love it.
And have you told them what's going on with that?
Not yet.
Are you going to? Not yet? Okay. Not yet. Okay. Something coming soon.
But then, on Friday, the Great Comet cast album was released for pre-order, and they released Prologue, the first song from it, as like incentive for you to get it. And so I've also had that on repeat.
Yeah, I listened to it too. It was really good. So it's available on Spotify, and we also put a link in the show notes
to like literally every platform where you can like pre-order the album and listen to Prologue.
So when does the album come out?
A month from today, May 19th.
Okay.
I'm ready.
Alrighty.
To wake up.
Okay. Alrighty, I think that is everything for this segment. So let's move on to the next one.
And now we're going to talk about our March, April, May Sheepy Spring Cal.
Yes, so this started on the 1st of March and it runs through the 31st of May. It's for any project you knit, crochet, weave, or spin that you can convince us is related. It's spring. How do they do that? How could they relate it to spring?
Oh, by it, your project's color, colorway name, purpose, pattern name, design element, or if you can't think of anything, you made it in the spring.
Yep. And there's been some beautiful stuff posted this week. Mm-hmm. Oh my goodness. I love looking through that thread. Okay. The big number one rule that we are very much sticklers about is that no whips are allowed. So you had to have started this March 1st or later and finish it by the end of the cowl. Feel free to poly dip in other cowls though. That is totally fine with us. We have lots of lovely prizes that are on the screen right now. If you'd like to know more about them, you can go to
geekygirlsknit.com.
There's photos and links there, or tune in to the first podcast of every month where we talk about them in detail. And thank you so much to all our sponsors for your support of our knit along. Every project you finish and post counts as one entry into the giveaway. You have to be a member of the Geeky Girls Knit podcast group on Ravelry to participate. The hashtag is GGKSS17. We'll lock the FO thread the morning of the 1st of June and draw winners on the next podcast after that. You'll have 30 days to claim your prize if you are a winner or you forfeit it. And there's a chatter thread in the group to cheer us along. And I saw just before we started recording, I can't remember who it is, but someone is knitting a project out of Sparkle Duck yarn because the dyer of Sparkle Duck unexpectedly passed away this past week. So that's pretty sad. We met her at Unwind Brighton in 2014. Mm-hmm. And you remember the Endless Rainbow that I knit, the Martina Bem one that mm-hmm. was mainly pink, but then the stripes and the diamonds were a rainbow sparkle color, and that was from Sparkle Duck. Mm-hmm. And I also knit you a pair of socks out of Sparkle Duck, the purple ones, purple and black ones. And then I did a scrappy pair of socks out of her stuff as well. Mm-hmm. So, our thoughts and prayers for that family during this difficult time. Okay, Dami, a lot of people finished projects this week, so why don't you give them a shout out?
Okay. A1 Dawin, AA Lauzon, Allison Roseboom, Anna Robin, Bijou Garden Gifts, CJ Bullion, Clarissa Joe, DG White, DQ Shelty, Eileen D, Frosty, Frymeister, Inagata Danita, Ingard Stoka, Jania Ami, JP Music 15, Juliet 23007, K2P2 Mama, Cat Wings, Nidasaurs, Knit Central, Knit Princess 83, Knitter Chow, Nitty Moomin, Little Angel SG2, Maria Wilhelmina, Wrath Delay, She's Knitting Socks, Shirley Knits 123, S. Keeling, Skyly Knits, Sylvia 1002, Tabby S80, The Knitting Dane 78, Yarny Mom, and yes, that's Shelby.
Great job, everybody. So keep working on those projects. You have a little over a month left to finish them. I just finished another triangle. I've got to bind it off with very little yarn left.
Come through. Yeah. I thought you said you had to bind it off.
I did bind it off.
I thought you said I have to bind it off.
Just that last stitch.
Oh.
That's all the yarn I have left. So, yeah. So keep working on those projects and get them posted and... yeah, great job, everybody. All right, let's move on to the next segment.
And now it's time for Ask the Geeky Girls, a part of our show where you ask us things and we try to answer them.
That's right. The question is for you this week, but I'm probably going to answer it too.
Okay, you're bouncing.
Oh, sorry. I was trying to wake up my foot. My foot fell asleep. So this week's question comes from Kim, who is VT Kimmy Kim on Ravelry. She is from West Virginia. So, Kim asks, Dammy.
Yes.
If you had to live in a musical, yeah, the in got left out. If you had to live in a musical, which would you like to live in and why?
Actually, I want to hear your answer first.
Oh, dear. A couple of them popped into my head. Well, actually, three possibilities. So, White Christmas. Because White Christmas. I mean, there's no need for further explanation. White Christmas. The Sound of Music. Although, like, I don't want to deal with all the Nazi stuff.
I don't want to deal with the Nazis.
But, yeah, her singing on the hills, and the hills are alive, and we'll start at the very beginning. It's a very good place to start, and good night. Oh, love that movie. And then, like, for a more recent one, La La Land, I'm really kind of in love with right now. I mean, there's lots of them that I'd love the music to, and I would like to, like, sing the music, but I don't know that I want to live in that musical. Like, Hamilton, I don't think I would want to live in that one. So. I don't think I would want to live in Ghost Quartet, because I don't really want to be a ghost. So what about you? Oh, wait, okay. I have a prediction.
Okay, like you said, I probably wouldn't want to live in Ghost Quartet, because, like, it's too complicated, and all the relationships are too complicated and stuff.
And I don't want to be Toast, either.
And Hamilton, I don't know. I probably wouldn't want to live in that, either. I don't know why.
There's a lot of fighting and war going on.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, yeah, like, even after the war's over.
Yeah.
Yeah. But, The Great Comet would be pretty fun to live in.
That's what I thought you were going to pick.
Especially with the abduction dance number every single night. The whole cast just, like, dances for 5 minutes straight.
But would you want to live during that war?
Well, they're in Moscow, and the war can't touch them there.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. Because I don't know. I don't really want to live somewhere where there's a war going on.
But Andre isn't here.
Andre isn't here. Ah, this was a hard one. Do you have any second choices after Great Comet? Newsies would be so fun to live in.
There's a strike.
strike. I'm trying to think what else is in our musical playlist.
I don't want to live in the Book of Mormon.
Oh my gosh, but that is so funny. We were singing it to the Hubs this week. Oh my gosh. What else is in our music? I would not want to live in Phantom of the Opera.
You don't want to live under an opera house?
No.
Come on.
I wouldn't want to live in My Fair Lady, I don't think, or West Side Story.
I mean, I get West Side Story, but why not My Fair Lady?
I don't know. I don't want to talk with a mouthful of rocks.
What?
Don't you know that scene? Where he's trying to teach her, no, it's marbles, a mouthful of marbles.
Okay.
Where he's trying to teach her how to speak properly. What else is in our playlist?
Lots of things.
Can I open your the playlist here?
Sure.
Or do you have a link? Is that it right there?
It's close.
No, I meant, is that Spotify, the link? I'm trying to think what else is in there. Pippin? Neverland? Finding Neverland?
Finding Neverland, maybe, but not Pippin.
Chess?
I don't think chess, either.
No. There's too many wars going on. We don't want to live in a war. Dear Evan Hansen.
That's too close to real life.
Yeah. That's Hamilton. Phantom of My Fair Lady.
I don't think Cabaret.
No, definitely not Cabaret.
Rent is fun, but it's sad.
It is very sad. I wouldn't want to cry all the time.
And Chicago is about crime.
Grease. That could be fun.
Yeah.
It could be fun. Don't make me wear leather pants, though. Evita. There's too much war going on in that one, too. See, we don't want to live anywhere where there's a war. Singing in the Rain, that could be fun.
Yeah.
That could be a lot of fun.
I don't want to be an animal and lying.
No, I don't either.
And I don't want to be eaten by a plant.
No. I, like, clicked something and I'm trying to make it go away. Wicked? I don't think. Aladdin, that could be fun. We could fly on carpets and talk to genies. Buffy the Vampire Slayer musical episode. No. I would be singing.
You are clicking on things.
I'm not trying to. See, it's got that thing popped up and it won't go away. Fiddler on the Roof? Maybe. Beauty and the Beast. I would totally live in Beauty and the Beast. Why did I not think of that one immediately?
Preludes is too trippy to live in.
Oh my gosh. Mary Poppins? I don't know. Maybe.
Are we going to scroll through this whole thing? Because
yes.
It is almost 10 minutes long.
No, we're only at 7 minutes.
That's almost 10 minutes.
Newsies we talked about. Great Comet, Ghost Cartel we talked about. Chess we talked about. In the Heights.
In the Heights is very fun, but then it gets sad in the second act.
Yeah. We already talked about West Side Story. Newsies. More Hamilton.
1776 is also war.
Yes. We're against the
and
wars.
It's more speaking than music.
Little Women?
It gets sad.
It does get sad. Camelot? Mm-hmm. Hunchback of Notre Dame?
No, Notre Dame.
And
there's death. Lots of death.
Waitress? I haven't listened to the whole thing of Waitress yet.
It's cute, but I think parts of it are sad.
We're against war and sadness, apparently.
Les Mis is too much death.
Too much death. Oh my gosh, The Color Purple.
Miss Saigon is too much sad and death.
We already talked about Book of Mormon. I haven't listened to all of, how do you say it, Aida?
Aida.
Aida, I haven't listened to all of that.
That's too sad. Hades Town, there's, I don't think I want to go to Hades Town to work in the mine, so.
No.
No, if we can just stay on top the entire time, that's fine.
More Beauty and the Beast and Moana. Maybe. So what you should gather from this is that we are against war and death.
And sadness.
And sadness. Other than that, let's go for it. All right, so I was going to say in the episode thread on Ravelry, we're going to ask them what musical they want to live in and why. So you can tell us. But also, if somebody has a question for us, what should they do?
Go to the Ask the Geeky Girls thread in our Ravelry group and post it.
All right, let's move on to the next segment. We made it to the end.
Yay.
Yeah, this is a war and death and sadness free zone, apparently. And it makes Dammy tired too, apparently.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So we have a couple of reminders. One is for about the 12th Doctor sock kit, which is a kit I'm doing with Julia of Pandia's Jewels. It is available for pre-order. The link is in the show notes. Make sure you don't miss out. I think it ends Sunday. So if you want to pre-order it, you should go do that because the pattern will be released to them first, and not until everyone that has pre-ordered the kit has the pattern will it go be available for the public. So if you want it first, go sign up. Or go place your pre-order, I mean. Just a reminder that in May and June, we will be co-hosting the Awesomest Cal in the Galaxy with Jilly, who is Vegan Jilly on Ravelry from the Knitting Broomstick podcast. And it will be for anything space-related. And if you can make it space-related, you're allowed to enter it. So it'll be the same as we've done in the past with her, where the FO thread will be in our group and the chatter thread will be in her group. Mm-hmm. And we have lots of lovely prizes. If you want to donate a prize, though, feel free to PM me, Java Pearl, or Jilly Vegan Jilly on Ravelry, and we can work out the details.
Instead of calling them cows, we should just call them owls.
The Awesomest Owl in the Galaxy.
For a long. The Awesomest Owl.
In the Galaxy.
Because it's short for Along.
I know. The guy from Quantum Leap, his name is Al.
Al! That's the Awesomest Al in the Galaxy.
Awesomest Al.
Right. Al Calavici.
Yes. Okay, do we have any other reminders?
I love the Great Comet. Go pre-order their album. I say this having not pre-ordered the album yet.
Okay. Well, let's say thank you to everyone who supports the podcast. We love you guys.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
You have stuff stuck in your tape.
I know. Would you guys like to hear the sad...
No.
What happened to my poor little pinky finger? So you guys know that I had fake nails put on for the book photo shoot.
Do they know?
I think they do. I think I told them. I had fake nails put on for the book photo shoot and for Edinburgh Yarn Festival. And when I took them off... My pinky nail, the actual nail, lifted away from the nail bed, but only in the middle. And so now it's growing out both sides, but not in the middle. Quit laughing at me. This is not...
really funny.
It's not funny.
You're laughing.
It's not funny.
You were laughing.
I'm like, because it's weird. It's weird. So anyway, we're doing some stuff to treat it, but one of the things is to use medical tape to hold the nail down so that hopefully it'll reattach.
Hold it down.
So thus, I have medical tape on my pinky finger. And I can't paint that fingernail. I told Dammy I should cut out a pretty piece of washi tape and put it on so it can be like a...
Put washi tape on all your nails.
No. I would paint the rest of them and then put washi tape on that one. Okay, how did we get to this? Oh, because I showed my...
We're saying thank you to people who
thank
support
you.
The podcast.
Yes, whether it is watching every week, giving us a thumbs up on YouTube, commenting on YouTube or in the episode thread on Ravelry, telling your friends about it, subscribing to our channel, downloading on iTunes, participating in our owls, which is apparently what we're calling them now.
Our owls.
Our owls.
Not owl.
No, owls. Owl. Owl.
Owl.
Owl.
Owl, you know, the guy with the cigar.
Owl. How else are they supporting us? Oh, giving us stars and reviews on iTunes. Just generally being awesome people. but a human...
We really like it when you participate in our owls, though.
That's the best. It's awesome. Participating in GGK Crafty Bad.
That's kind of an L.
That is kind of an L. Oh my gosh, you guys. I don't even know what I'm saying. Oh, supporting the podcast. But a special thank you to those of you who support us financially. There's three ways you can do that. One is on Patreon, which is a site where you pledge a certain amount each month. A certain amount each month to your favorite creatives, and you get rewards based on the levels that you pledge at. So if you want to know more about this or just or want to sign up, you can go to
patreon.com/geekygirlsknit.
What's another way?
There's also a PayPal button in the sidebar of our website if you would like to make a one-time donation.
And the other way is we are amazon.com and .co.uk affiliates. If you go through our website first and then shop, we get a little bit of money back based on what you purchase. It doesn't cost you anything extra, and it's a great way to support the podcast by doing something you'd be doing anyway. And most of that money goes to shipping prizes, which I shipped out a bunch of prizes this last week. I've got another one over there to ship. The post office was closed on Monday when I was out, so I couldn't do it. So it'll have to wait. But again, thank you to everyone who supports the podcast, no matter how you do, because we would not be doing this if it wasn't for y'all. We love you very much. I hope you know that. This is getting all sentimental and emotional.
Ow.
So, Dami, why don't you tell them where they can find us online?
You can find us at geekygirlsknit.com. There are links to everywhere else we are online: YouTube, iTunes, Ravelry, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, etc.
Yes, and with that, we're going to tell you goodbye. We hope you have a lovely rest of your week, and don't miss out on joining in our owls. We're seriously going to have to change this now.
Our owls.
I like feel like this is going to be a new thing. This is like poly dipping.
So it's not our sheepy spring cow, it's our sheepy spring owl. Just don't change it on the image. You don't have to do that.
Oh my gosh. Okay, we're telling them goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Have a great rest of your week. Happy knitting. Talk to you next time. Bye. I don't remember all the words before it. I don't care if I can be there on the street where you live.
I won't care if I can be there.
Here.
Oh, no.
See, now I'm confusing you. She corrects me constantly all week long.
And then she confuses me.
When I'm singing songs from the musical playlist. I do that quite often with the Hamilton ones because there's so many words so fast. And I'm just like... Lafayette!
That's not even trying.
Lafayette! Hercules Mulligan! Those are my favorite parts. I think you know that. I think I've told you that before. Go find a musical, sing it, and embarrass your children. And dance. And just make them be like, my mom is crazy. And then be like, embrace that. Embrace that craziness.